click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, welcome back to Electromagnetic Field Theory. We are in chapter 2. Today we are going to see electric field intensity, which is very important vector from the electric field of electromagnetism or electromagnetic field, moreover we can say. As like we know, light source has light intensity. If that particular bulb or light has given more wattage, more power, the light intensity will be more. So the intensity defines strength of the source. For electromagnetism, we know that the charge is the reason, or charge is the source of electric field. Whereas for magnetic field, current is the reason, or current is the source of magnetic field. If the source has more magnitude, it produces more field. So what is the measurement parameter in which we come to know whether the field is stronger or weaker? So here for electric field, we have that parameter, electric field intensity. It is basically a vector. So how to determine the electric field intensity for electric field produced by certain charge? Let us see the details. In the previous lecture, we have gone through the concepts of Coulomb's law, which has given us the force of interaction between the two charges. The force of interaction may be the force of attraction, or may be the force of repulsion if the charges are like charges. And we have also solved simple three numericals based on the concepts of Coulomb's law. Now, what is electric field intensity? Now, let us see first of all the situation that we have studied in Coulomb's law. In Coulomb's law, we considered two charges into the space. Generally, if there is any static charge, the region surrounding to that particular charge in which the influence of this charge is experienced is called as electric field. As like we know, the king rules his kingdom. Here, the charge rules the surrounding, and that surrounding is called as electric field. Now, we have to judge whether the electric field is stronger or weaker. So that we have to do in terms of electric field intensity. So here in the space, we consider the two charges. Again, we denote Q1 and Q2. The polarities may be like or unlike. So depending, the force of repulsion or force of attraction will be there. Now, to test the strength of Q1, in place of Q2, if I put 1 coulomb of charge. Okay, so then according to the Coulomb's force law, in scalar form, what we have, F is equal to Q1 Q2 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R square. So here, in place of Q2, we are putting 1 coulomb. So Q1 into 1 coulomb upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R square, this becomes Q1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R square. So in this case, this term gives us the strength of charge Q1 at a distance R. If the Q1 is positively charged, and we take 1 coulomb of charge near to it, 1 coulomb, this is also positive, so it will repel. As we approach very near to Q1, the force of repulsion will be increased. As we go very far from Q1, the force of repulsion magnitude will go on decreasing. So this way, the strength of Q1 has to be determined. So what exactly we have done here? We have taken the force F and we have divided it by the magnitude of second charge. That means we have put Q2 is equal to 1 coulomb. So the definition of electric field intensity can be done like this. Electric field intensity is a vector which is obtained by division of force of interaction between the two charges upon the magnitude of second charge. Okay, so this is F bar upon Q. So F bar is in newtons, Q is in coulombs. The unit of charge in SI is coulombs, the unit of force in SI units is newtons. So this can also be done in the form of voltage per meter, V by M. Okay, so this is electric field intensity. The electric field intensity gives the strength of charge. So in general, we can write E bar is equal to Q upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R square. Now, what is this R? In the formula for force given by Coulomb's law, we have taken R is the separation distance of separation between the two charges. Now here the concept of field point and source point comes into the picture. As I have given the bar over here, I must put AR cap. Okay, so now see, if this is the charge, the region surrounding to it influenced by its existence is electric field. So this is the source point where the charge is present and because of which the electric field is present. If charge is absent, there is no electric field. Now in that particular region, in that particular field, if I take any point where I have to check the strength of that particular field, so this is called as field point and this is called as source point. The field point we can take anywhere as per desired. So it can be far away from the position of the source point, it can be near to the position of the source point. So according to the relative position of field point with respect to the source point, the strength of that particular field in terms of electric field intensity denoted by E bar is going to vary. Okay, so electric field intensity we have defined, that is E bar is equal to F bar upon Q, and the generalized formula we have taken, E bar is equal to Q upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R square AR cap. Now always remember that it is in volts per meter or newtons per coulomb. The direction AR cap, if the charge because of which the electric field is present, if it is positively charged, then electric field intensity always have outward direction. If the charge is negatively charged, suppose negative charge is present over here and the surroundings is influenced, so this is the electric field of negative charge, then the electric field intensity direction is always towards this negative charge. This is the direction given by AR cap for electric field intensity. So the generalized mathematical representation for electric field intensity we have. So what is this epsilon 0? We have already discussed, it is permittivity of the medium. So if we put 0 as suffix, it is permittivity of the free space or air. So epsilon 0 has the value 10 raised to power minus 9 upon 36 pi unit is farads per meter, or the epsilon 0 value is 8.854 into 10 raised to power minus 12, again the unit is farad per meter. Both the values are same, anyone you can use. This value is more convenient to cancel out pi while solving the numericals. Okay, so now the direction we have discussed, the epsilon 0 we have discussed, R is the distance from the position of charge Q, that is source point, to where we are checking the strength of that particular electric field, that is field point, distance between source point to that of the field point. Now this formula gives us the representation in terms of Q. So it means Q is a point form. So this formula is applicable to the charge in point form. Now the charges can have different kind of configurations or forms, you can say, what we call charge configuration. So let us discuss about the charge configurations and system of charges. So before charge configurations, if suppose this is charge Q1, this is charge Q2, this is charge Q3 and so on up to charge Qn in the space, and at this field point we are supposed to determine E bar. So here we will first of all take the electric field intensity at this field point because of this source charge. So let us represent that one by E1 bar. Now, electric field intensity at this field point, because of this charge Q2, that will be E2 bar. Similarly, because of charge Q3 at the field point, it will be electric field intensity E3 bar, and so on up to En bar. So, electric field intensity E bar due to system of point charges is nothing but summation I is equal to 1 to n Qi upon 4 pi epsilon 0 Ri square Ari cap, unit is volts per meter. One more thing, why the volts per meter unit is given? See, whenever the accumulation of charges to some place is there, we say there is certain voltage with respect to ground. Okay, so now in the electric field, here it is the source charge. It may be 1 coulomb, 10 coulomb, 100 coulomb, in positives or negative, it can have any value. So depending on the magnitude, the strength of that particular field is there. So the potential at this field is maximum. As we go away in the electric field, the potential reduces. Okay, the potential or voltage, we say, potential is measured in voltage. So electric field intensity we test at any field point, it is relative to the distance of separation from source point to field point. That is why as we go away from it, it reduces, hence the unit is volts per meter. So now the electric field intensity due to system of charges, we have the generalized representation. Now let us have a look on to the charge configurations. So charge configurations can be of three types in general. They are line charge, surface charge, volume charge. Now let us see one by one. What is line charge? Suppose we have a point charge. Beside this point charge, we have another point charge, another point charge, another point charge. This way, if the accumulation of charges are there that are aligned in one direction, so it means this particular line is entirely charged. If the charge configuration is uniform, so for such a line, we cannot take out some portion and find out the exact charge value. So in such cases, we have to take the help of charge density. So charge density for line charge is rho L. So rho L is the total charge on the line upon its length, measured in coulomb per meter. So the charge configuration, first one, is called as line charge. Now practically the line charge may be having the finite length, or for theoretical derivations and calculations, we can have the line charge of infinite length also. So the charges that are aligned to a linear direction is called the linear or line charge configuration. Now there may be any sheet of conductor where the charge accumulation is there. For example, we talk about the two plate capacitor. The two plate capacitor is like, we have these two plates. These two plates are separated by certain dielectric in the capacitor. Suppose negative charges are accumulated on this plate of capacitor and the positive charges are accumulated on this plate of capacitor. So here the sheet or the plate of this particular capacitor has surface area. If we put certain charge over to that particular plate or sheet, that charge gets uniformly distributed. So taking out a small portion, we cannot exactly get the value of charge as it is uniformly distributed. So here also, in this case, we call that configuration to be the surface charge configuration, and we take the help of rho S, called as surface charge density. So it will be the total amount of charge onto the surface divided by the surface area capital S. The unit of rho S is coulomb per meter square, as this is the area. Now the charge can be in the form of volume distribution also. There may be any certain volume, any arbitrary volume. in which certain amount of charge is uniformly distributed. So such case we get the help of rho v, which is called as volume charge density. The volume has the multiplication of three dimensions, length into breadth into height. So volume we measure in terms of meter cube. So the total charge divided by the volume will give us volume charge density. So rho v we measure total charge upon volume v. The units will be coulomb per meter cube. So here we have three types of charge configurations: line charge, surface charge and volume charge. So for line charge configuration, the shape of accumulation of charges, okay, which will be the effective charge to produce electric field, will be a line. So here we take the help of rho l, line charge density measured in coulomb per meter. In the surface charge, the accumulation is over any surface having certain surface area. We take the help of term rho s, called as surface charge density. The unit of measurement is coulomb per meter square. And for the volume charge, we have certain volume where we take rho v the term. So here coulomb per meter cube will be the unit. Rho v called volume charge density. So now we have gone through the formula for point charge configuration. So for point charge configuration, we have E bar is equal to Q upon 4 pi epsilon 0 r square ar cap in volts per meter. So in place of this Q, we can have different configuration representations. So for line charge, we can say capital Q is nothing but the integration over the line, let us say from L1 to L2 if it is a finite line, or rho L into dl. If this is the line, we take the differential part, we denote it by dl. It may be dx dy dz in rectangular coordinate system. So the line charge density multiplied by this differential length will give us the charge. So integration over line, okay, single integration. So we can put this representation in this numerator if the charge configuration is that of the line. Now if you have any particular surface, so in that case the Q will be given by double integral rho s into ds. So ds may be defined by, let us say, dx into dy. So rho s is having the unit coulomb per meter square, ds in meter square, so this will give you coulomb. The total charge representation will be the double integral, that means integration over the given surface, for surface charge density. We can put this in terms of Q in this particular formula. Now if there is volume charge distribution, then we can write Q is equal to triple integral rho v dv. So for any region, we can find the dv differential volume. So multiplication of the three parameters, and we integrate it on all the dimensions. So in place of E bar is equal to Q upon 4 pi epsilon 0 r square ar cap, we can put this particular bracket for volume charge distribution. So based on these concepts, we will solve certain simple numericals in subsequent lecture. Thank you.